Hello and welcome to this week's Welcome to the Podcast. I hope that you will really much enjoy this week's Welcome to the Podcast because we actually had a really big effort on getting people together this week because Philip couldn't do it. And this week will be Emil, Emily and Gaming Ghoul plus me, of course. And we will sit in 1 hour and talk about stuff. I hope that you pretty much enjoy it. And if you do, please do like this video because it helps a lot. So that was all from here. My name is Lalpai and this is Welcome to the Podcast.
Hello and welcome to the podcast.
Hello.
So, hey. What?
What should we talk about today?
I think that I have told you that like, twice yes. More are times today. Are you serious?
Are you serious? I'm gonna talk about it just so that they know.
I've tried to tell you this all day.
I know, but I just said it so they know what we should do because.
No. We do not talk about our schedule. That's not a part of this podcast.
We don't talk about the schedule.
It's not.
So we don't got a schedule.
We got a schedule, but we just not talk about it.
Shut up, Emil.
Yes, because if we talk about our schedule, then people just want us to be just show us to the schedules, and we don't want to do that. Okay. So, hello, Gaming Ghoul. How are you this week?
I'm so tired.
You got an upcoming exam, so you
I have an exam on Monday.
Yes, and Philip couldn't be here because he also have an upcoming exam. So this week we also got Emilia again. Whoa, you were here last week.
She was.
Wow. Yes. I'm sorry, but last week we had to record in the evening instead of the day, which means that Emil, you couldn't be a part of this podcast because. That was just how it was, but you wasn't forgotten. And you today stepped in instead of another guy, so yes. Yay, so my heroes. You took Mikkel's place because we were just not sure where he was. And
yes. Maybe on a bench in a park somewhere, maybe. So drunk.
Mikkel and Alpi on the bench.
Evening on this. Sunday and don't know where he is.
Have you seen that movie I made with one of my friends called Mikkel? Not the guy who should have been here, but another guy from Hustle. It was me and him sitting on the bench filming ourselves with a GoPro camera while we were drinking vodka. And they are laughing at a girl dancing. Yeah. Oh my god, Emil, you are red. You're so beautiful, Red.
That's what's survived from the computer. Sorry. I'm doing something else.
Sorry. I actually want to talk about what it is to be live on the internet, because we are actually live on the internet, Emilia.
I know.
You know, this time.
Yeah.
This time around, you actually know that we
still remember the first time.
The first time we made this podcast, and I said,
where are you getting all those questions from? You didn't know we are live on the internet.
We are twitching this because we want to.
Oh, stop yourself!
Gaming Ghoul is just dying.
Please stop it.
No, Gaming Ghoul is trying to stay awake. She's been studying hard.
You should drink some more coffee.
I can't.
She's even talking about herself in third person. That's not a
She's
good
talking
time.
About herself
gaming
in third person.
Gaming Ghoul always talks about herself in first person. That is the third rule of Gaming Ghoul.
But you just talked about yourself in third person, so you are
I think
third rule by the first
No, shut up, Emil. That was a joke. Don't not explain it. Do not explain the jokes, okay?
Emil, no one wants your opinion.
Ouch. I do.
He's evil.
I know.
We have been making fun all day of Emil.
But of course, it's because you don't got a soul.
Yes, we're going to talk about that later. So, guys, What do you think about the being online on the internet aspect of also welcome to the podcast, but also the live streamers on Twitch and the YouTubers out there, the guys who are live on the internet, other than us, right now.
Well, unlike us.
Unlike us. No.
They're popular.
Popular or not the so popular, because see, on Twitch you actually have people who is not that popular but still is live on the internet. So like a regular guy live on the internet, like on Twitch, what do you think about that thing? They're gaming, or there's some of them which is doing podcasts, and you can see people playing DJs and making music on the internet now on Twitch. And I think that's a whole new aspect of the being live on the internet, because before you had YouTube, where you could put out a video sometimes, and sometimes people will watch it. Now you are live on the internet, which means that people can watch what you're doing right now, and they can't go back later and watch what you were doing. They are only looking at the thing right now. And that aspect of the being live on the internet.
Yeah.
Opinions?
That's kind of true.
A live broadcast. Like when you're looking at the television, for example, that's also live. Sometimes.
No.
Sometimes.
That's when I watch it.
Sometimes.
Never when she watches it.
No.
I missed Euroversion. I'm still sad about that. I was studying and I forgot it.
What did you forget?
Euroversion.
Euroversion. Oh, Eurovision.
Do you remember, Ryan? I forgot it.
Eurovision was like last week when we were doing a podcast. We were doing podcast in the middle of Eurovision, and we all just missed out on it.
This is all your fault, by the way.
This is all my
fault. It's your fault I missed it.
Yes, it's
because
my fault.
I forgot Eurovision.
And you did go back and watch it because it was live. Right?
I forgot. Yes. I can't watch it again. It was live.
It was live.
I have to find some shitty internet, and that's totally annoying. I'm not even sure I want to watch it. I just need to hear all the songs.
You just need to hear all the songs.
Yeah, it's important.
Yes. So Emilie, yay.
Yeah.
A running joke now. So Emilie,
what do you think,
should have been there. We are going to talk about it in 50 minutes time, but
you were pointing to nowhere.
What are we talking about?
I am asking Emilie the aspect of being live on the internet. First time you were live on the internet was actually on Welcome to the Podcast, and you didn't knew. But even after you knew that, what do you think? You are now alive. You can't just stop yourself. I can't just if your little brother walks in naked again on the screen, I can't just censor him because this is live. I can try, but I can't just censor him. And the aspect of the live production, now you're live on the internet, there can be tens of thousands of people seeing mistakes now, and everything you do will be recorded.
Yes,
that aspect. I think it's a bit scary, and you need to be a bit professional about it. What am I doing now? Why am I doing this? And yes, I just needed another word. Why am I doing it? And how am I doing it? Because I'm a douchebag. Why are we alive?
No, you're a douche.
A douche.
La douche.
Yes. Do you know why we are live on Twitch? Because we didn't have to, unless my computer goes totally haywire again and we go blue screen of death, which meant that, like last week, I actually lost about 1 hour of footage. If it wasn't because of the Twitch broadcast recording, which means that everything that I say will be recorded to Twitch so I can download it if stuff goes wrong. That's why we're live on Twitch. Doesn't mean that we actually have to pay attention to our audience.
Yes.
What do we do?
Yes.
In other aspect of actually being on the internet will be the I'm on YouTube. Look at me. I am making videos. I am live on YouTube. I make videos for fun, and I started it as a fun business. But I think that guys like you might watch YouTube videos out there. And what do you think about those guys who makes YouTube videos?
Depends on what kind of YouTube videos we're talking about. I didn't listen.
You like what YouTube videos do you watch?
Are we talking like this where we have this opinion-ish talking, or are we talking gaming videos or vlogs?
I think he means videos in general.
In general, the YouTube, yes. It can be. I watch music on YouTube. I watch music on YouTube. When I need to listen to some music, I go to YouTube and I listen to it. But also,
I use Spotify.
You use Spotify, but I don't.
So much easier to listen to music on Spotify.
I do not want the Spotify commercials because they are just made of evil. And
evilness itself.
Yes. You can use to it, man.
And Spotify is just so freaking low quality. On YouTube, they uploaded it in AFFF.
I would say often some of the Spotify versions of the songs are better than on in YouTube, but that's like some albums aren't. All the songs of some of the albums out on YouTube from the creators, but they are on Spotify.
Yes. If you think about it in the music aspect of it, on Spotify you can go and you can listen to new music, and sometimes newer music comes out on Spotify before it comes out everywhere else. But when I was young, whenever a new music video came out, I had to watch it on MTV or we had that
VH1
or The Voice, or I had to in Denmark on the Danish television. We had the I think it was called Boomer.
There was some kind of program.
Ten.
But still, if you're not interested in the music video, Spotify is a pretty damn good place to go.
The Pirates won.
I still go to YouTube to listen to some music because you can't find everything on Spotify. Yes. Like, you can't anything from Taylor Swift. You won't find anything from Taylor Swift on Spotify.
Because she does not want to sell her soul on Spotify.
She doesn't want to sell her music on Spotify.
Yeah.
Spotify has absolutely no effect on how she produces her music, therefore she can't actually sell her soul to Spotify.
When I go to Spotify and listen to some music, Spotify tells me that the commercials for Spotify is going to pay the musicians, but they just get not enough. And they guess even
yes,
and they get even less than you get on a YouTube video.
Yeah, but then there's all the other aspects of things, like most musicians, they make practically nothing from Spotify and YouTube next to what they get from selling merchandise and going on tours. They sell nothing on CDs on the tracks themselves anymore. It's really a dead market.
Yes.
Because everybody's just streaming it.
Yes.
Yes.
I watched a show or a documentary made by big musicians like Mike from Linkin Park and Slash and some of those really, really old musicians. And they said that nowadays everybody can just open up Spotify and they can just download the music and they just turn up the volume and listen to it through their crap speakers or their crap headphones. And for these headphones, I actually have used a couple of hours to tweak them so I can have just some sort of good sound. And even though...
Well, so have I.
So have you.
Dude, what would the point of buying an expensive headset and not tweaking would just be useless.
Yes. But in most cases, you buy a expensive headset, buy a expensive speaker, and then you just can listen to the speaker and say, "I have to only tweak this a small amount, but this speaker is good." But because headsets are so small, you're just confined to what you can get in there, and that's not a lot of stuff. This is LMG, and sometimes I have problems with high noises, like when you blow into your mic or saying S. And
S.
Yes. So that annoys me. And this is because it's headphones. But the musician says that the music is just too compromised today, and you can just stream it all over the place. And if the musician wanted us to listen to crap quality music, maybe they have made crap quality music, because then they could just put it out there on fucking USBs. But no, they make high quality music, and they use a lot of time and effort on it sometimes. Now you're just fucked, because it's just crap sound coming out of your expensive headset, because Spotify's crap.
No, that's what I'm telling you.
Yes.
The quality on Spotify will from time to time be better than it is on YouTube.
Yeah.
It will.
Yeah.
Which is why I use Spotify a lot, but I also use YouTube a lot.
Yes. But
you have a preference. Preference is still allowed.
Yes, of course. But even on YouTube, you have a problem.
But then again, my headset is tweaked to work with Spotify and not with YouTube. So that's a point too.
My headset is just tweaked to actually just have a good sound.
I have different tweaks. Like, I have one for when I'm just listening to music, one for movies, one for when I'm gaming different games. It's really different.
Oh, sounds. Sound is actually a
complicated.
It's complicated, and it's science. But Emily, I think that you would actually agree with me. Bad sound just kills music.
Yeah, does. If the headset or your speakers not really can put out the sound that you really could hear with a good headset or a good set of speakers, it just actually just killing the music in some point.
Hmm. It's like sometimes I have the feeling of when I listen to some music that it's like the music is playing from the next room and the door is closed. That's what I'm hearing. Speaking of sound kill and music, I was at my old venue where I worked. They choose to, because it got too hot in there sometimes, they choose to have a sprinkler system all over the place, so they made the venue into a rainforest, or at least as wet as a rainforest. And it only meant that you felt that everything was hotter, because when you hire the humidity... No. when you hire the density of water in the air, and it gets more humid, you have a problem, because now it's just feeling hotter. But also, when you spray water over a in front of a speaker, then you kill all the high tones. And I seriously mean, now you're playing into a wall. Now you're playing into a wall, because now there's just water between you and the audience. So it was sometimes.
Besides that, when you add more air to the, you add more water to the air, the density becomes thicker and thicker and thicker, until the point where you basically can't really breathe, and that becomes a problem too. Which is why it's so hard to breathe in rainforests and stuff like that. The density of water in the air is so high.
The density in the air will just be.
The density of water in the air
would be so hot, yes. But also, yes, it's hard to breathe, and it has to actually also speak and hear all the high pitches, like Emily's voice would actually just get lost in there, because now she's talking into a wall of water. if you higher the density of water, and because the system was made so it will fall 3 meters through the air in front of the speakers, and now after it will hit the audience and vaporize instantly, which means that now you have falling water which is not vaporized. And when it hits the audience, or just before it hits the audience, it will vaporize, go up again, and now you have steam and water coming this way. It's just way too hard and stupid. And who got that idea? In a venue where you were supposed to have good sound, now we just hire the density of water and make it more humid in there. So it was just, it was just stupid. Okay. So this afternoon, we were actually some of us playing some board games.
Yes.
Yes.
And that was fun.
One second. First of all, the first of them left, and then the next one left. Oh, that's a dog. It's a beautiful dog.
He was going to bark.
So he's so beautiful.
He was going to bark. So I let him in.
I just love your dog in some way.
He is the cutest.
Now your microphone is at your mouth again. I'm sorry.
I knew that.
You knew that.
Of course.
That's why it's
so. You could never be in doubt.
That's why it's so important to have a headset with a monitor in, so you can hear what you're saying and you can hear when you breathe into your microphone.
Oh, I have that, but I turned it off because I don't like it.
You don't like it. You don't like the sound of
your
voice.
I don't like it.
Yep.
I don't even know.
I got used to it. Sometimes when I turn it off, I just think that where did my voice go? I can't hear it anymore. So yes, we were playing some board games. And yay, it was so beautiful.
No.
Okay. I didn't win.
No.
Have you heard about the game called Red Dragon Inn?
No.
If you haven't, Emilia will go to explain. I can see that on her.
No. The dog says no. Come here.
It's... He says, kind of where you're
no.
playing.
Shall I tell it, or do you just wanna?
Okay, Emil.
Go ahead. The dog says yes.
The dog says yes.
It's a game
where you are playing in. You're playing a drinking game as your character with some other characters, and. Emil, you just take over from there.
It's a board game where you are playing some characters after they just killed the dungeon, and they go into a tavern, and then they play a drinking game and try to drink each other under the table and play poker and win.
Oh, I kind
well,
of...
The, I got the poker pot down.
There is a... In every basic set, 4 different characters where you have to choose between the each deck. Like, when you're playing Magic, you have one deck which can kill one kind of deck, and you have another deck which can kill another kind of deck. And they always be in against deck. In our Roleplay Society club, we have 2 main... games, which means that we have 8 characters to choose between. The game goes like... Emil, will you force that? will you
Emil,
continue?
Emil, are you going to say go on?
You're going to continue sure. from here.
I don't know.
I'm getting eaten alive here. Nobody's...
I could just see that on you. Like, when will he
Dog is
going
to eat her.
Oh, you were looking Dog at Dork.
I have treats.
There's a beautiful dog.
There's a dog. Why is it always the dog takes this show over?
No, it just does sometimes. It's a beautiful dog, and we like her
he
dog.
He steals the show every single time. He's perfect.
He's so
and
perfect.
And so fluffy.
Show stealer. Okay. The game goes like you start by drawing a no. You start by discarding the cards in your hand you doesn't want, and then you draw up to 7 cards. Afterwards, you take an action card in the game and you put it down. Read what is the text on it. Does as I say, go to a buy drink phase. Take a card from a drink deck. Pile, put it into another drink me pile, and then you drink the
drink
top
me.
Yes, then you drink the top card from your drink me pile, and then you have some characters which just can't be drunken over, and some characters which can't be beaten, and some characters which just can't lose money. Now it's your job to find out what to do with the different characters, and then just do it. And no. The dwarf can't win over the cleric unless they play poker.
Well, as Emil, I know poker, so I can win.
Yes, but in Red Dragon,
Lumpy, it's not really a kind of poker
I
because
win.
They are using
I
cards
win.
And dice in it. So
it's like they pay you when you start. You pay a coin, and then you play a card like gambling. I'm in. And then you take over the round, and then another can.
I win everything, right? It's I win.
Yes, you win, of course.
Like, and then there's a card called Winning Hand, and that means you just won.
That's just,
unless
that's
the other player cheats.
That's my entire deck.
Yes.
That's unless the other player cheats and take
or
it
race.
From you.
Unless the other player cheats a race, and. They can also play. They can cheat, and they can raise. If they raise, you can play a winning hand again or a gambling. I'm in, and the other stuff. So
if
they say,
cheat, I kill them and still win.
Yes, of course. There's also a card to negate other people's gambling. I'm in. Yes.
Actually, it would be fair. When I play poker, I usually count the cards.
Usually.
Well, if there's money on the table, it's pretty clever to count the cards.
But this is not a real gun. This is for fun. It's like you take your Dungeons & Dragons character, and those character who plays gambling, or gamble, is those
yeah,
character
but
who drinks.
You still gotta win.
Yes, of course
you still
gotta win.
Right?
Yes.
Yes. But you gotta win. Gotta win the game.
Yes, you do.
So.
Yes.
What now?
We have also been playing a lot of Cast Against Humanity.
Yes. Are we gonna play it and stream it?
I think that the later we are going to play it and stream it. But the.
It seems like. Yeah, it seems like.
Speak
we
right
lost
now
because
her mother started to play music in the room, so she can't really turn on her mic.
Yes.
So we are one player down.
I think that we should have a quick break here or something.
So we're gonna
yes.
take a break.
And yes, we're going
back.
To take a break, and we're going to come back. Everyone just has to hang on. So stay put, and we will be
we
back.
Half
in,
covered, or
we're what? Just half covered. So we will be back.
So
I'm going to find
a
solution.
Break.
We're going to take a quick break. Hello, we are back after the quick break. Emilia had to switch from her computer to an iPad. But that's just how things are sometimes, and we just take everything with a smile. So we say hello to Emilia's
you
beautiful.
Take it with a smile.
I need to take everything with a smile here. I need to just find solutions quick and easy. That's what I'm educated to do. I was not educated to find the hardest solution in the longest time. I was actually educated to find the quickest solution in the shortest time. And sometimes just use duct tape instead of wheels on a truck, because sometimes you just need to. What do you say that I have
Lumpy,
a leak?
Lumpy, this comes as a surprise. I didn't know you were educated. You don't seem very educated.
No, I'm not educated.
It all comes as a surprise.
Andrew, we are over time in some way, and the guy actually misses in some way now, but it's okay. Everything is going to be fine.
Not if I get eaten first.
No, but as I said, everything we're going to be fine. Okay, I think we continue from I'm here 30 minutes. So, where did we go to? I got to.
We went to Spain.
How far? We went to Spain. Did you go to Spain? Spain is a beautiful country.
It is.
That's so annoying.
Yes, everything is going to be his own line. That's beautiful dog. Just have butt sex with it if you want to. But
never do. What are you?
You know that this channel has become a rated R for rule, right? You know this channel is rated R now. Because we
do
just...
that, but that doesn't mean you have to talk about shit like that.
No, I'm not.
I really thought stuff like that would be over when he wasn't here anymore, but no.
No. No, when Philip was not here anymore, that stuff would be gone. But we were actually about to talk about playing Cards Against Humanity live on Twitch.
Shall we do that?
We should have done it right now, at this time, because we should have been done with the podcast now. But the problem is that we have technical difficulty, which means that
always.
So it means that we now only are going to talk about Cards Against Humanity. And what did you expect from Cards Against Humanity? I know that I think Gaming Ghoul, you have played it before, right?
A couple of times.
So
I expected to have fun, and it kind of worked out. I won, so yeah,
you had a good time. You had a good time.
It is physically impossible for me to lose.
No,
right?
It's not. Was it first round? It's first round. She was all down. Was it 1 point?
You know, if you keep talking like that, you're not gonna.
I'm not gonna live very long. I know.
We're going to find you, and we're going to give you to Gaming Ghoul.
Oh no!
And you know, there's a reason why she has a lock on her door and not on the inside. So
I also have a very hungry dog.
And I really
a fluffy dog like
yeah, but he does love red meat.
Yes.
He's gonna tickle me to death.
So Emil, I think that when I introduced you to this game, or when I did not introduce you to this game, Cards Against Humanity, what was your expectancies? What did you expect?
Me?
Yes, what did you expect from the game?
Me?
Yes.
Yes, God. I actually played it before.
You played it before?
Yeah, in my class. So in school time, we played it while we had English. So we played Cards Against Humanity. And it was fun.
But you know that game is about... touching butts and not touching butts, but it's just a really rule game, and it's against humanity. It's just being what would you say?
Offensive.
It is offensive. Yes, it's just being offensive for being offensive, and it's actually good at it.
It is.
And I am the tutor of the game, often people actually choose to save their most offensive cards until it's my turn and just play the most offensive combinations of cards just to see what would actually make me laugh the most, because I just like offensive stuff. Which actually gave Emilia a lot of points.
You can make
at some
a combo,
point.
I think, where what's that smell? And then it's some, I don't remember his name, but it's someone's delicious butthole.
Someone's delicious butthole?
No, I don't know the name, but it's...
I don't know, but that's just offensive. Emilia, are you still with us?
I think she died.
I think she died too. Okay. Some new games which are about to come out. I've heard that they... What is it? Heroes of the Storm is about to come out.
Yes.
Am I the only one who have played that still?
I haven't played it, but I really kind of want to play it.
But I think that we tried to provide you with a better key, and you haven't played it with us. It's a good game. It's a League of Legends clone, but not really.
I think it was with somebody else, because I'm not remembering it.
I think that me and Philip has given out a million better keys now. And we have. Everybody who wanted a better key, we just gave them away, because we had a bunch. And it's because when you're approved to have beta access... Not if you're given a beta key, but when you're approved to have beta access, you get a beta key, and you have 6 spare beta keys you can give out to 6 friends which you want to play with. And I think that some of those guys who got beta access just thought that, I'm just going to assign for a beta key and hope that I get one. And when they just get one, you like my totally serious voice, didn't you? And when they get one, they're just like, I'm just going to be noob at this. I don't know how to play computer games or use a computer. I think that I've used my nose and my thumb. That's just annoying to play with. I hate people who play Heroes of the Storm because most of them is just noobs, and all the pro players is just left out now. It's because all the pro players still play League of Legends. What?
In other words, Lulpy truly, sadly hates himself because he himself plays the game.
Yes. You know that you're totally pixelated right now, right?
I know.
You know. Okay.
And your mic is sound like crap.
No, it does.
She's back.
Not for me. Shut up.
Mike, iPad through my headphones on my when I'm on my iPad, she doesn't really. Her microphone is not that good.
Well, that's your iPad, not my headset.
But that's a little strange because Lulpy and Emil are going fine through it. So
that's fine. Do not attack each other now. I don't want to be a host of a warfare here. Be happy and happy. Yes, but just be happy. Emilia, the Cast Against Humanity.
Yeah.
I introduced you to that. What were your expectancies of it? Because I didn't think that I told you about it before we just took you into the game.
I didn't really know it, and I played, and it's. Don't really have that much to say about it. It's just.
It's offensive?
What?
It's offensive. But the offensive perspective of the game where you have to choose a card and then there's a chooser. You have to pick a card from your hand, give it the size of the black card, and then someone chooses. And the most of the cards is just offensive. What
some
do you think about that?
Some of them are offensive, some are not.
Of them is just funny. And what do you think about that? You know, it's nerd who made it, and the most nerd is just...
I don't really thinking so much about it. I'm just...
Okay.
She's just playing it and rolling away.
Yes. Just trying to offend a fool. Okay, I just lost the total way of talking right now.
Yep.
Offend a fool. Okay, I can't talk. Gaming Ghoul, go!
Go. Where?
Go, save his ass.
Spain?
Spain?
I'm not gonna save his ass. He's doomed.
I am doomed.
Oh. Speak, you say, a function very few people possess under pressure.
Okay. And what is that? What is that function to speak? So we
speak.
Emil, have you played some beautiful games lately?
Sounds.
Something that you think that we should hear about?
Me?
Yes, you.
Because I mean, I always doubt if it's her or me. But games I've played
recently.
Actually, I played a very old game. Oh, old and old. It's
yes?
some years, but I still think it's funny, and it's called Prince of Persia. It doesn't really know what this is, but I know
think
it
that
is
actually the newest one, the newest Prince of Persia, the one that they didn't get any credit because it was so fucking bad.
I think it's alright.
Okay. It is that Prince of Persia where you have a princess with you, right? And she saves you every time you die and stuff.
I think that, yeah, that's
this
the one.
This is a new one, yes. So in the old Prince of Persia games, you actually have a game over screen, but they just deleted that because it was too hard to die. So now you just have to try over and you can't die because Prince of Persia and the prince never dies. You can't lose that game. That's just not funny. In the old games, you have to push your buttons and smack your face into
chill.
The controller.
Chill.
You had to.
Chill.
And
no.
Smack your face
chill.
Into the controller.
I just think you like rage games.
No. In the old games, you had to push all the buttons at the same time and smack your face into the controller in order to do that jump.
Oh.
It was so hard, but it was funny because it was so hard. Now you just saved by a princess if you doesn't smack your face into the controller anymore because you doesn't have to. It's just way too easy, and the games in the new era is just way too easy, and it's actually annoying because now everybody can be a part of the gaming community. No. I'm sorry, I'm raging here, but I don't think that everybody should be a part of the gaming community because not everybody is good enough to be a part of the gaming community. Or better said, there are some games which are not for you. And there's a lot of games which is not for me. Like, I do not play The Sims because I can't win that game. But I tried.
Did you just, one, assume that I play Sims?
I didn't say anything.
And two, say that there are games not for me? Games that I can't play?
Games you can't win.
Are you sure you want to go down that path?
I am going down that path. I will actually challenge you to win Prince of Persia 2.
I don't
Shadow...
have that game.
No, but I can just send it to you. I have it. I will send it to you and you have to complete that game.
Is it for the PS2? Because I only have PS2.
No, it's for PC. I will...
It's for PC? Yeah, I will win that game, and when I'm due, you're going to have to eat your words and your shoes.
I am going to wait. And a guy I know, a bold guy I know... called Ronnie. He is playing a lot of games too, and when I saw him play that game, he got so frustrated at some points that he just threw the controller into the wall of the PS2.
I'm just gonna tell you
he
one
was
thing.
So
I've
frustrated
been games
that
like
game
Prince
is hard.
Persia since I got my PS2.
Okay,
just
but
so you know.
Okay. Then there might be another game out there which is not for you. Because
I can
like...
play all the games if I want to.
Okay. So I don't know because I'm saying that I can't win Sims, for example. I can't win SimCity and I can't win those maxi games because those games is just not for me. I ain't good at economy. And I'm just stupid like that. I'm good at playing games which challenge me in push this button at this time or do this at this time, or like MOBA games. I'm good at MOBA games. And I'm good at Prison Architects, I think. But actually in a really bad way. I'm really, really slow. I have been playing Prison Architect for the last week or so, and I don't think that I progressed at all. I feel that I progressed a bit, but not at all. Not enough. And the progression curve for me is just too low to... It actually is fun to watch for Crumble, because it just takes...
For me, it's like...
Yes?
No matter what the game is, if I get my hands onto it, I will play it until I complete it.
Until you complete it.
Even
yes.
if, until
even
like,
if you
even
don't
the
like.
Sims.
Yes. So if
even
I...
Even if I hate the game with everything I have.
You can't complete
so,
Sims.
So
if
you,
I feel
if
like...
If I'm gonna give you Hello Kitty, you're gonna play it.
Oh my god.
I'm just saying,
are you gonna do that?
Hello Kitty games.
It has to be hard.
I have completed multiple Hello Kitty games because...
Oh my god.
People didn't think I care. I am a strong gamer.
You're the strong gamer. You are
I
the gaming
I will take
ghoul.
The challenge and I will destroy it. I am gaming ghoul.
And yes. So,
But that's... I think it's because in the community...
You can't do that now!
You just said, like,
girl! Girl, you can't
do
that now because you can't ruin my podcast! Please! You know that I have to move a lot of stuff around when you do that.
And I love it. Sorry.
Okay, I like you. I still like you. That's,
I was
that's...
trying to get it to work, and now when I finally
got
get
it
to work, you're hating me.
And that's not good.
I just think it's the upside down world.
No, it's not the upside down world. I'm just saying that you can't do that now.
But I can't! I just did it!
But now everything is totally ruined. No, it isn't. Everything is still fine and we will all be happy.
Happy!
Yes, I'm just going to... Yes, I'm just going to... What?
Someone wrote something in the comments, but I reloaded and didn't see it. What
someone wrote... someone wrote that someone delicious a butthole best eaten to a podcast. Oh, thank you. I'm sorry. In this Twitch chat or channel, we have a rule that means that there are no rules for moderation, and enjoy your ban. Okay, so I am just one of those guys who, if you offend me and say this is a butthole podcast, then just don't watch it. But please, I don't want to hear your opinion. And that's actually mean. And I just ban people who are mean to me. I have no problem in doing that. But apparently people are thinking that it's all right to be mean to each other on the internet because it's the new norm. I'm raging when I play Heroes of Storm, yes. But what?
It's actually a thing. A social study has been done on it with anonymity or whatever you call it, you know. Other people, we don't know that person personally. We won't really be able to get a hands on this person personally. They're not saying it directly to our faces. It's just such an old thing in a way, because their anonymity does that they can say whatever they feel and think, and yes. They can be mean to others and think that there won't be any consequences because they're unknown to the people they say it to.
Yeah. It's like... Yes,
that's also a part of being live on the internet. Sometimes you have to deal with problems like this. Sometimes you have to deal with problems where a guy comes into your Twitch chat and he just say, "What is this, a butthole podcast I ever have heard and listened to? You're shit and I hate you, but..." Just enjoy your ban. Because I don't want to listen to that stuff. But apparently yeah. people want to offend me with that stuff, which is just annoying. And therefore we have the rule. And the I will say it, that there's some rules on the internet, and rule 292 is there are no real rules about moderation. Enjoy your ban. And it means that I can just ban people if I want. I can ban you right here, right now. For no reason, because there are no rules for moderation on the internet, which also means that if you're mean to me, I can just ban you and enjoy it. And I have to deal with that stuff, because I have to actually think, do I want to ban this person, or do I not want to ban this person? Do I want to give this person a second chance? When you actually is mean on a League of Legends, they come to you and say, this is what you said. And we are going to lift our finger and say, do not do it again, please.
But that's the thing about League of Legends, it's not a very effective. It's not very effective.
No, it's not effective. And
like me, I never say anything rude. I'm never rude or anything, but I will still get reported because I'm a newbie. So I'm just started. I'm not even playing in the big leagues. I'm playing in a little league.
Yes. But in League of Legends you can't do that. Yay! And Ronnie says that we are awesome. Ronnie, we will join you in 10 minutes or so, and then you can join this beautiful stream. Yes, because our podcast will stop in about 10 minutes. But yes, being rude on the internet is just stupid. Because okay, I can sit here and rage. I can sit here and say, oh, butthole people can't play games, but but seriously, I do not tell it to them personally. I do not say that if you were a bad gaming ghoul, I wouldn't tell you that you were bad, but I would rage about it, but anonymously. You would never notice that I did it, because that's just the...
No, but you still...
In my personal room...
Dude, I know I'm bad at League of Legends. Yes. That's not.
But in my personal room, where nobody else than me and the guys I'm talking to over Skype can hear me, I can rage all I want, as long as the person I rage about is not hurt about it. It doesn't hurt me, and then I don't have a problem. But what do you think about that? Would you have a problem knowing that somebody might be raging about you out there?
I know,
but not telling you.
Probably are.
Yes, but would you have a problem with somebody are raging about your gameplay but not telling you? Or would you just say?
I don't kind of got a problem about that, because I never know.
No. Or would you just say, I play the game the way I does, and I am a newbie. I'm a bit of newbie also in Heroes of the Storm, but that doesn't mean that I have to tell people. That, or it doesn't mean that people doesn't have to tell me that I'm a noob, because sometimes I am, and I was at one point so newbie that I died all the time in League of Legends, and some of my friends never played with me again. But
oh, that's sad.
That's sad. But
that's kind of what happened to me.
But they never told me. And at that at that point, I was just offended.
You know, I know I'm bad because I'm new. I haven't been there too long. I haven't played for a long time. Some of the people you play against have been playing for years.
And I think that
experience, especially in games like League of Legends, they make a huge difference.
It does.
And I know that.
It does.
It's not a one-person game. You have to make it work with a team. And I'm bad at team things. When I don't, you know everyone on the team.
Yeah.
So I know I'm bad. And if other people are talking about me, telling other people I'm bad, then fair enough.
Just let them.
Not now, my now problem.
Now I just want to play a game of LoL. And a play of card.
Yes. I think that we have about 7 minutes left or so.
7?
Oh my god, 7 minutes.
Flies.
Summarize. Yes. We will, after those 7 minutes, we will have a short break on this channel, and then we will go and play some Cards Against Humanity. But guys, Gaming Ghoul, Do you have anything to bring to us in this week, which is provided so we can know who you are and tell us about yourself? So I can find you on the internet, or should I just say that there might maybe be a link to a Tumblr somewhere in the video description of Welcome to the Podcast? Or do you, or should we just read up what Pfizer just said?
You know what that? You know what? Yeah. You know what? Yeah.
What? Yeah. What? We want to read it.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's read it. That's
a good point. I'm better at reading. Yes, but I'm better at reading. Wait.
Who's gonna read it?
You.
You.
Oh.
It's vote. You're gonna vote it down.
Many people consider themselves. Many people consider themselves games. Consider themselves playing games on a very high skilled. Competitive. You know what? This is still not fair because I'm word blind.
Okay, I'm going to read it then. Many people consider themselves playing games in a very high competitive level. Therefore, there are some wrong reasons feel like they are taking, talking all the flaming and blaming on the new players who just want to learn the games. Many gamers like the beginner gamers like the beginner games and or sort of games into the categories to eliminate a lot of flaming. However, it is to someone offensive, and the developers are afraid of being too aggressive towards the subject. And yes, the developers are actually afraid to be to attack the subject and go, you should not do that. And they, like Blizzard did in Hearthstone, I would imagine that many people would rage, but in Hearthstone you can't rage because you can say sorry or well played, but you can't say anything offensive. You can just say thanks or sorry or well played or things like that. I think there's six sentences or so. And now my Twitch chat just goes wrong. I'm trying.
No, I mean, are you even keeping an eye on the comments? This is actually a pretty funny comment. Whoa.
And my IP. No, you can't have my IP.
But no, dude, are you even watching what Fraser is writing?
Fraser? Can join and read it for us. Nope. We are going to wrap up now. And
so cool.
Yes. So, Gaming Ghoul, who are you? Where can I find you on the internet? That is the always question, and I think
always question, never fully answered.
We can find you if we may find you if we can't, and I might maybe in some day put a link to a Tumblr thing in a video description of a podcast. Emilia.
Yeah. Well,
you
we are ending it.
Our art. What the fuck is that? I'm trying to talk here. Emilia, you're our artist in this podcast, and the singer. So if I'm and you paint the unicorns, right?
But
on
yes,
the internet.
I am.
And you do
I'm
for money, right?
I'm also doing other stuff. I'm.
Yes, you paint on computers and stuff.
Yes.
And if I want to see your drawings, where should I go?
Where should go? You should go to my Facebook page where I will put a link, or I will give Lalpi a link to that.
I have a link.
Yes, you have.
So,
a link,
so she has a Facebook site, and there will be links in the description below or on our Facebook, and. If you are interested in Emil is nowhere on the internet.
No,
he might have a Facebook profile, but he doesn't use it.
A little.
Yes.
But I'm actually just the guy who helps them work at some role-playing things, and I'm
just not pay attention to that.
I take in sometimes and talk and opinions, and that's all I can.
Yes.
Pretty sad.
Yes, my name is Lopai, and I am a YouTuber, a live streamer, and a orc guy. I play a lot of games, live stream a lot, like 12 hours a day, some days, and some days only 8 hours. I have a YouTube channel where I do a daily vlog, which means that daily I will try to upload a video about my boring life where I play live streams and I talk with people over the internet and pretend that I is good at making podcasts and so. And sometimes I also go to walks. I'm also a light technician, which means that sometimes on my YouTube channel you will find the content from light shows which I made. I also have a Twitter where I will tweet out about the things I do and be stupid and funny, and sometimes rage. And all of these things you can find in the description below. Go down there, under Emil, and look at all these shitty stuff. And who is going to wrap up? I'm not going to say
no
anything.
No one, because that's an obnoxious rant.
That's just abandoned now. We're not going to say it.
No.
Okay.
No.
A short wrap-up line. Take care, everybody. I like everything. My name is Lopai, and this was Welcome to the Podcast.